It would not be a show without talking to our good friend Luke from Luke's Lab.
Hello.
How you doing this morning, Luke?
It's another wonderful day.
All right. So the last time we talked with you, we were talking about the Pika, which is your hot end for the bamboo printers. You had that on Kickstarter, and how did that go?
The Kickstarter went well. We appreciate everybody's support out there. I am immensely grateful for the outpouring of the community for this particular hot end. I'm excited for you to get them as well. The update that I really have is, one, we are in mid-production right now. Things were a little slower than I expected getting the machine tool up and running. That is what happens when you have the 16th one of them in the world. So it's really cool, but it also comes with its own tweaking and turning of the actual machine itself. We think we're on pace for delivery by end of October. That includes to our resellers worldwide, and we're really excited about that. But I'll be posting more updates, so you can pay attention to that as well. Otherwise, on the Pika front, we actually found a source for non-PTC heaters in 100-watt variants. So we actually are releasing a maker's version as well. So for those of you who have like a Jabberwocky or are using the bamboo tool head in your like stealth burners or stealth changers and stuff like that, we actually have a 100-watt non-PTC version that'll drop right into a bamboo space and be perfect for your DIY builds. That's kind of something fun and new that we've been working on here as well. Other than that, on this side of the table, Jupiter will be coming back soon, maybe sometime. We do have another prototype run going. We're going to be going and testing it internally first, and then if we don't find anything terribly wrong, we'll have it available for an open beta where you guys who have been wanting to try it out and wanting to see what this can do for you, and I want to see what it can do for you. We'll be letting that go whenever we feel ready, because we want you guys to have at least a decent experience overall.
Sounds good.
Yeah. All right, moving on over to this side of the table, you may have noticed something a little bit more compact. So I know many of you out there, you may aspire to have a chew, but it might be a little difficult to pack in your ant head on a little teeny tiny burner. Have no despair, Tube Compact is here. So we're really excited because we've taken all the good things that you know and love about Tube, the dependable heat break, the titanium structure, the long melt zone, standard components, and we put it into something far smaller. So this is only 47.2 millimeters long. It's the same size as the original Mosquito. It fits in all of these tool heads. So it fits in a stealth burner, it fits in A4T, and plenty of other units here as well that I don't really know the names of, but that's okay.
Well, you've got a dragon burner there, Zoll, maybe?
I think so. Yeah. I don't know. So my apologies for not knowing everything. But also it fits in ant heads that I do know. Back there, we actually have a Rook with a Tube Compact printing in it. It's so cute.
Which is just insane to think about a Tube on a Rook.
Exactly, exactly. So even though we've gone with the smaller size, your melt zone doesn't necessarily have to be compromised. So this actually is a 33 millimeter melt zone before nozzle in this amount of space. That's as much as a Magnum Plus in this space. So you can be printing, this cube was printed here at 45 cubic. On this stealth burner at 45 cubic. That's on a 0.4, mind you. So that's, I like to think that's pretty good. That's pretty good. And for the first time with Tubes, it will come with a silicone sock. So the sock, made out of the same high temperature material that we sourced for the Pika, it'll be good to 300C continuously. And yeah, works really well.
Cool. And correct me if I'm wrong, but that sock will also work on the other Tube models.
It will not. So the Tube Compact has a slightly more compact outer diameter, and so it has a different sock. The sock will be coming to mainline Tube sometime in the future.
Gotcha.
Whenever I get the prototypes and samples and do that work.
Okay.
Now that we have a recipe and I have time to design these things. So it will be coming. Stay tuned. I hope to have it out soon. It'll be at a very fair price, and we hope that it'll probably become standard with regular tubes once we get to that point. So stay tuned there.
Awesome. So thanks for taking the time, and always good to see what you have coming up.
Exactly. Thank you.
Cool.